Good morning, everyone. And I want to welcome my guests. And this morning, I'm going to be responding to the recent report that was unveiled by the Citizens Panel on Increasing Organ Donations. As well, I'm going to go on record my support for MPP Frank Klee's Bill 67 on organ donations, and then I'm going to go on to explain why. But before I give my thoughts on these two matters, I'd like to do something special this morning. I wanted to present a 10-minute video, and it's going to be revealing my personal journey of battling Canada's organ shortage for the last 10 years. And it's based mainly on our charity, Step by Step, five campaigns. And it involves literally millions of Canadians. So during these past years, we had the opportunity to talk to people, hold debates and consultations in 500 communities across the country. But it also exposes the different levels of provincial government and federal government's neglect and mismanagement towards this issue. So this video is not intended to demean any one person's or party's character, but actually the opposite. It's to instigate positive action. And it is also in memory of all that have died on the waiting list for organs. This is a plea to our Prime Minister and all the premiers across Canada. Please make organ and tissue donation a priority in our country. It could be more important than saving lives.
There is a critical shortage of organ and tissue donations in this country, a crisis.
Class, don't forget that assignment on that inspirational story on organ donation. Make sure it's in, and thanks very much.
That might work. That might.
Hold on.
I'm gonna call.
And there's a reason.
Write this down. Step by step, organ transplant association. Thanks, I appreciate it.
Well, no one told me just how to get there. But when I get there, I know. 'Cause I'm taking it step by step.
One more funding cut, and then George is going to be raising awareness, I think, very significantly.
George, how are you holding it up?
The weather's been pretty unkind to me the first month and a half. I've had real scorchers and electrical storms following me.
This year, he walked across Ontario to increase awareness of organ donation. In response to Mr. Marcello's mission, and on behalf of the people of Ontario.
Like me, thousands of people across Ontario were inspired by George Marcello and the whole step-by-step team as he walked across the province.
I believe I can speak for everyone here today in wishing you the best of luck as you embark on your coast-to-coast journey, and I can assure you you have my support and our government's support.
With him, and we're hoping he can proclaim on behalf of the Vatican that they fully support organ donations.
George, a fellow North American from Canada, is in the studio with me right now. Hi, and welcome to Rome. Another ardent supporter of organ donation, namely Pope John Paul II.
With the Olympic Torch of Life, where today over a million people have held the torch as symbol of their support. And ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, please join me in welcoming Mr. George Marcello, who is in day number 541 of his 769-day
run. We should all be aware of the importance of organ donation. George Marcello, congratulations and thank you for what you've done.
Thank you, George.
And he's the guy that's going to do it. And I think it's an appropriate thing that he's here at the legislature to get some respect from the people that really need to see this done. Get some respect from the people.
Walk that I'm about to take will hopefully inspire everyone to be an organ donor.
From our journey, from the Canada 769-day walk, we're passing the torch of life to the youth of our nation and to the mayor of your town of Sarnia.
Are you actually going to light it?
one of my heroes. He's one of my heroes because he decided that he could change the world. One of my heroes. One of my heroes. One of my heroes.
By the wayside.
One of my heroes.
To the stars.
And one of my heroes.
Through our trouble. Some have to live with the scars.
One of my heroes.
There's far too much to take in here. Or to find that can never be found.
Another lesson learned. Better know your friends, or else you will get burned. Gotta count on me, 'cause I can guarantee that I'll be fine.
This is why I'm screaming at each community to get their attention.
No more pain.
Well, that's what's gotta be done. We gotta go into the malls, we gotta go into the schools, we gotta go into the churches.
Do we want to solve this issue or don't we? Because it's solvable.
Stop shuffling our feet. And let's get into business of saving lives now.
For years, we have mentioned that most of Europe had high rates of organ donations. Spain in particular led the world. I'm visiting these countries to gather important information so I can bring it back to Canada, and hopefully it'll help our country.
Listen for the playback. They say that every man bleeds just like me. And I feel like number one. Yet I've been gone for way too long. Maybe I forgot.
George received a new liver and a new lease on life.
Still I ain't seen mine, no, I ain't seen mine.
So up to this day, it's still unbelievable how all these different levels of government didn't accept our report and recommendations. Unbelievable. And what we were mentioning were things that are being echoed today or in the report that was just released recently by the citizens panel. And our research and our debates and our consultations was a combination of health officials and the public. And the other important part of our research was that we didn't just pick and choose who we were going to go to. That was some of the case. But a lot of times we went to places where we just went to people and started talking to them. So there was no rehearsal. There was no dress up. We were getting the actual opinions of your average Canadian across the country. So I have two very important things I want to point out. As witnessed in the video during the second campaign, when we woke up Ontario, I still have this burning question. Why was neither step-by-step nor I accepted as the part of the Trillium Gift of Life Network? After all, it was us that inspired the Premier to create this agency. So why didn't we become part of it? And why weren't all any of our recommendations accepted at that point? That's number one burning question. And if they did, and they would have accepted our recommendations, we would have already been working on some of the solutions that have been announced in this latest report. So let's just think about how many lives would have been saved had this agency accepted our recommendations and made us part of the Trillium. Two, why did the McGuinty government lead us to believe that we would be heard after the Harris government denied us? There was ample opportunity when we started Christopher's Wish, our fourth campaign, for them to accept our recommendations, which they said they were going to during the Harris government. There's piles and piles of reports given to every health assistant in the Ministry of Health offices, as well as the Premier's office, for the past 3 years now. So why and why did the panel, when I met with them, refuse to arrange a meeting with me and the health minister? Were they afraid that the report might have turned out different? So these are still burning questions, and I feel that they should be answered. I feel that somebody should talk to me about these burning questions. As far as responding to the report, which I read from back to back and read it very carefully, I want to first of all point out that this is a waste of taxpayers' money, the entire report. The citizens' panel was created by the health minister to find solutions for organ shortage. So why was this panel created when there is already a paid agency to do this job? And that's the Trillium Gift of Life Network. It's in the Trillium Gift of Life Network's job description to discover solutions for organ shortage. Why weren't they doing their job? And it says in their mission statement, and it also says it in their mission statement, and it's the reason why this agency was created in the first place. When Premier Harris created the agency in 1999, it was to find the solutions for organ shortage and to double the rate. So why are we creating another panel when there's already people that are supposed to be working? To me, the taxpayers are paying twice. So it's a waste of money. Most of the report and the recommendations that were given by the panel were similar to reports that recommendations from Step by Step had given for the past 10 years. And again, as witnessed in the video, most of the contents that I see in here are the same things that we gave the Harris government, and consistently through every government, and we explained it in news conferences, to the media, to the public, and we were very, very consistent with our recommendations. 10 years we've been talking about this. Now, do they expect us to believe that they just discovered something here in these recommendations? So to me, it's they've regurgitated information that was already there. The only difference between their information and our information is that they charged well over $1 million and we gave our information for free. So why would taxpayers want to pay money for information that we were given for free? The panel had plenty of money, resources, and time, and they were only able to produce 2,000 responses. We used to get 2,000 responses at one gathering. We've done 4,000 activities over the years. With all that time and money, that's all they could muster was 2,000 responses. Again, this was an obscene waste of taxpayers' money. I have here 1,000 responses from students at Queen's University. And the difference again, this report costs nothing, but it's totally different from what report that was given by the panel, and I'm going to get into that as my next item. And this is the inaccurate report on presumed consent. Many people know that during our reports and talking to Canadians across the country, that we kept letting the media and all political government bodies that Canadians were in favor of presumed consent. They didn't have a problem with it, that there was a minority that wasn't in favor, and that this system should be looked at seriously because it was working in 23 other countries and it dramatically increased the rate of organ donations. So we kept asking to we gave our report, then let's do a survey that can actually reflect what Ontarians are thinking on this. And the panel reported that Ontarians were not in favor of presumed consent. First of all, we question the sampling of this evaluation from the lack of turnouts and responses. We have to wonder how objective the results really were, because the panel went on to say that Ontarians are not supporting presumed consent. Were the people that were asked about presumed consent a true cross-section of Ontario? Most of the people I from the state, and it comes right from this book, is that there was a majority of people that responded online. And how was the question posed to them? You know, I found that when I talked to Canadians about this issue of presumed consent, you couldn't just ask them in one sentence, are you in favor of presumed consent or not? You needed to talk to Canadians about this before they can give you a better answer, or a sound answer, or a more thought answer. So you know, how were these people approached when they were asked about presumed consent? Again, I have a sampling here of, and it's based on 1,000 students that were approached at Queens. And here's our evaluations. And by the way, there was about 60% of these students were female and 40% male. And they varied from 16 years old to 25 and over. And 11% of the 1,000 didn't want to respond to this questionnaire. 0.12%, they were not sure how to respond, as they indicated on this paper. 14.5% were not in favor. As you can see, it's in this pile here. 74.4% were in favor, as you can see in the bigger pile. How can there be this big discrepancy with the report stating that Ontarians will not approve of organ donations, when we did a true sampling of Queen's University, and they overwhelmingly are in favor of presumed consent? Could the students be that far off from representing a voice of Ontario? If that's the case, then I think this report and this survey should be done over again, because at least we have a sample where it begs that there's two different statistics here, one from the panel and one from us. So it begs the question. Let's get the true statistics from Ontario, but let's do this right. Let's not create another blue panel, a blue ribbon panel. Let's create a real cross section of Ontarians to participate in this, so that we can give the true evaluations of what Ontarians think about this issue. Because having the government of Ontario putting this off until after the convention, after the elections, we got to look at, well, how many people on the waiting list have to pay for that by dying? So is it fair to the people of Ontario to accept a panel that made a report based on 2,000 people and what we feel wasn't a true sampling? Is it fair, based on that, to put off the whole idea of presumed consent in our province? I don't think so. And the public should start voicing their opinions on this. I mentioned earlier that I was supporting MPP Frank Klee's bill, Bill 67. I support Bill 67 because it is a step in the right direction. We need, of course, to go further, and I want to make that clear. But if this is a government gauge on how far they will go at this time, because Frank's bill is in its second reading, and I think it's ready to be tabled for the third reading today, I am in favor of it. The bill is still alive, and this bill, it raises the a lot of questions, and it also raises in Ontarians the possibility that could eventually opt out at a later stage. I was at Mr. Klee's public debate last week, and just judging from the responses I was hearing the public stated on his bill, I feel it is a step getting closer to eventually presumed consent. My final thoughts on this report and the whole issue of organ and tissue donations. I believe that the government must know that our organ crises will not get solved anytime soon. The nature of and the timing of this report is suspect. I see it as a big sedative so that the public would be complacent and until after the elections. So how convenient? Well, they have me in step-by-step to deal with because, and of course the rest of the problems, because we're not gonna let this go to sleep. We're not gonna fall asleep. I also wanna mention that to completely solve this issue, Ontarians, and for that matter, Canadians, need to be challenged. How badly do we want to solve this issue? If we can give up our freedom to be in harm's way for our country, then what is the opt-out system asking? Certainly not to kill another human being to defend our country, but simply to agree to make a system easier to save lives. The freedom is knowing that you can opt out. Our freedom in lives depends on the kindness and grace of others. Allow us a system to embrace this kindness collectively. This non-conditional freedom is worth it. If it is considered a sacrifice on anyone's part that objects to this, then I beg you, go to Sick Kids Hospital one day and see the children whose lives and freedom depends on what us, the society as a whole, do. I beg you to do that. Thank you very much. So I see I have no media here, and probably be no questions, but please visit our website, step-by-step, one word, .ca, and I respond to everything by email, by phone, and please, if you want to download this movie, it's on our website as well. Thank you.